the show. It's time, let's go. Grab your friends and get ready. Here comes our friend Nanny. Let's open up our Bibles. Become true disciples. Y'all ready to grow? It's the Nanny Show. Let's go. Let's go.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the show. I'm Mr. Dan, here with my good buddy,
Mitty! Woohoo! Ah, it's finally almost here!
What is?
Christmas!
Oh yeah, it's gonna be so much fun.
And I got you a present, Mr. Dan.
You did?
Of course! And you got me one, right?
Do you even have to ask?
I just did.
No, it's an expression where, never mind. Of course I got you a present.
Is it a giant go-kart? Or maybe even a giant motorbike? Or maybe even a giant candy bar? Or maybe even a giant bow tie?
I'm not telling. I want it to be a surprise.
Okay. Have your secrets.
Well, today, everyone, we are going to have a blast because our main point is, drum roll, please. Is that a drum roll?
Is it not?
I guess. Our main point is Christmas is all about Jesus.
Oh yeah, that's awesome.
When we remember that Christmas is all about Jesus, there's no way we could have a bad Christmas. Jesus is our King, our Savior, and our best friend. God gave Jesus to Earth as the ultimate gift.
Wow, what an amazing gift.
It really is. All right, everyone, repeat after me. Christmas is all about Jesus.
All about Jesus.
One more time. Christmas is all about Jesus.
All about Jesus. Oh man, wow, Mr. Dan, that's awesome. Okay, Mr. Dan, are you ready to open Christmas presents?
Well, not yet. Plus, I have to go down to Godfather's Pizza to see Randy to get your gift.
Copy that, good buddy. I'll just wait here patiently.
All right, I'll be right back.
Okay, see ya. Guess I'll just do some Sudoku while I wait. Where is my Sudoku book? Sudoku book!
Oh, what's up, everybody? I'm Tank, and today we're gonna talk about the core values. First up is love, love guitar, yeah! Oh, wait, no, that's not it. Oh yeah, Mr. Blake said, love God, because God loved us first. Next up is love people, because God loves all people. And the way that I like to love people is to give them a show. Let's do the love people chord. Love people. Next up is do your, it rhymes. Best. Do your best, because God will do the rest. Let's do your best spin. Do your best. The last core value, and my personal favorite, is have fun, because God gave us joy. Let's sing it out together. Ready? 3, 2, 1, have fun! Yeah! Rock on, everybody!
making pizza, pepperoni.
What's up, Randy?
Whoa, Mr. Dan, long time no see, broski.
Yeah, broski, good to see you.
What brings you into Godfather's Pizza? You want a slice of our new goat cheese pizza? People say it's not too bad.
Sounds good, but no thanks. I'm actually here to get Nettie's Christmas present.
Oh, right on, right on. I love presents. All right, so what do you have in mind, Mr. Dan?
Well, our main point today is Christmas is all about Jesus.
Very cool.
And that got me thinking about our verse, Romans 5:8.
Oh, Romans 5:8. I'm not familiar with that verse.
You want to check it out?
Oh, of course.
Let's hit it.
Right on.
Hey everyone, it's me, Miss Ashley, and it's time for our memory verse. Remember, we do our memory verse so that you can keep it in your heart all the time. Our verse today is Romans 5:8, and it's an awesome verse that demonstrates just how much that our God loves us. So when you're ready, say, let's go.
Let's go!
Awesome. We're gonna say the verse three times. First, I'll say it, then I'm gonna say it, and you're gonna repeat after me. And then we'll say it all together. All right, let's go. God showed his great love for us by sending Jesus. Woohoo! Romans 5:8. Okay, now repeat after me. God showed his great love for us by sending Jesus. Woohoo! Romans 5:8. Great job. Now let's say it all together. God showed his great love for us by sending Jesus. Woohoo! Romans 5:8. That was incredible, everyone. Now remember, keep saying it and keep it in your heart.
Whoa, that's an amazing verse, bro. God loved us so much that he gave us Jesus.
That's why Christmas is all about Jesus. It's the day we celebrate Jesus coming to earth.
Wow, that's amazing.
Plus, when you accept the gift of Jesus into your life, the gift never fades away. Jesus will always be with you.
Whoa, that's incredible, bro.
It really is. And so while I was thinking about what to give Nettie, I was inspired by God giving us a gift that lasts forever. So I came here to see if you could help me think of something.
Let me think. I think I might have an idea. Come here, bro.
Man, that's perfect. This is gonna be awesome. He's gonna love it.
Right on.
Okay, awesome. Hey, before we give gifts, we always tell the story of Jesus' birth. Would you like to help us with the story?
Oh, totally. In perfect timing. My shift just ended.
And how about on the way to the treehouse, we listen to the song Christmas is All About Jesus.
Dude, you read my mind, broski.
Let's hit the road, broski.
Oh, yeah.
Yo, this is our Christmas rap.
Don't sleep, don't take a nap,
'cause we're spitting Christmas truth.
Yo, Nettie, hit that sound booth.
Yo, it's little Nettie. It's Christmas time and you know I'm ready. Prepping presents and pizza in this house. But Jesus is what it's all about. He's the best gift ever. Living for it forever. He's a gift that never fades away. So I'll share him every single day.
Christmas is all about Jesus. Christmas is all about Jesus. Christmas is all about Jesus.
Hey, Mr. Blake, you're up.
It's all about Jesus.
Our Lord was born in a manger. His love is a real game changer. Make room for the King in your heart. Then you and Jesus will never be apart. We love rapping about Christmas, 'cause it's all about Jesus. Now you know Christmas is his day, so there's only one thing left to say.
Christmas is all about Jesus. Christmas is all about Jesus.
Christmas is all about Jesus. Christmas is all about Jesus.
Christmas!
Hey guys, Merry Christmas!
Nettie, bro, so good to see you. So excited about Christmas and the gift that Mr. Dan got you.
Oh, can you tell me what it is?
Well, no. Before we do any gift giving, we've got to tell the story of Jesus' birth.
Oh, right on. That's exciting.
Sounds good.
This is the story of Jesus' birth, but told in a cool way. Nettie and Randy, you guys mind helping me out?
Oh yeah!
I'd love to help!
All right, here we go. One day, a woman named Mary was walking down the road to a well. Then she saw an angel of the Lord. His name was Gabriel. Gabriel said to Mary,
"You are going to have a baby, and you must name him Jesus."
That night, the man who would marry Mary, Joseph, was visited by an angel in his dream.
"Bro, you will have a son with Mary, and you will name him Jesus."
Okay.
So Mary and Joseph got married. After they got married, the Roman Empire made everyone return home, pay their taxes, and sign a contract.
Sign the contract.
I don't want to.
I'm going to Bethlehem. Yeah. Go.
So Mary and Joseph had to go to Bethlehem because that was where Joseph was born. The journey was long and filled with challenges. They became very tired.
So tired.
So tired!
Once they finally got to Bethlehem, they knocked on the door of the local inn.
"Can we come in? My baby is about to have a baby, and it's very tiring. Do you have a place to stay?"
"My place is, my rooms are all full, but you can stay in my stable."
"We'll have it."
Oh, sorry.
Once Mary and Joseph got into the stable, they had to figure out where to put baby Jesus when he was born. So Mary was like,
"Where are we gonna put this baby in?"
And Joseph suggested,
"A manger. Let's put him in this one."
But Mary said,
"No way. You're not gonna put my baby there. Chicken pooped in there."
So during the night, they were sleeping.
Snoring.
Then Mary had baby Jesus.
"Oh, look, it's a baby."
In a field nearby, some shepherds were looking after their flock when an angel appeared to them and said,
"You must follow the star to the stable.
Don't forget the music."
"Oh yeah."
But the shepherds were scared. So now the shepherds had to take the journey to see the newborn king.
"I can bring you your sheep."
"This is so hard."
Once they finally arrived, they were like,
"He's so cute!
Aw, he's adorable! Lullaby! Lullaby!
Lullaby,
lullaby little baby!"
Then everyone celebrated.
Yeah!
And that is the story of the very first Christmas. The end.
Wow. That was a little bit of a different telling, Mr. Dan.
It sure was. We had a lot of fun doing it, though.
Oh, yeah!
Jesus came to earth to set us free from our sins. He made a way for us to be with him always. That's why every Christmas, we should remember that Christmas is all about Jesus.
Oh, that's awesome. All right, I gotta go get Nettie's Christmas gift. I'll be right back.
All right, see you later, Randy. Hey, Nettie, you want help finding that Sudoku book?
Yeah!
All right, let's go find it. I think I saw it over here.
You were the Word at the beginning, one with God, the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed. You are beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. He didn't want heaven without us, so Jesus, you brought heaven down. My sin was great, your love was greater.
Today has been so much fun talking about the true meaning of Christmas, Jesus. Romans 5:8, God showed us his great love for us by sending Jesus. God sent his only son Jesus so that we could be free from sin and live with him forever. Jesus paid the price for our sins on the cross, then 3 days later, he rose from the dead, and now he sits at the right hand of Father God. And what's really cool, he wants to be your best friend. And the best part of that is, all you have to do is ask. It's really simple. All you have to do is pray and ask Jesus to be your best friend. Repeat after me. Dear Jesus, thank you for giving your life on the cross for me. come into my life, forgive me of my mistakes, make me brand new, and be my very best friend. Lord, I love you, and I thank you. And it's in Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people said, amen. Wow, if that was your very first time asking Jesus into your heart, then I want you to know that I am so proud of you, and I want you to tell someone in your life that you love and trust, because they're gonna be proud of you too.
Oh, Mr. Dan!
Mr. Dan! Oh, are you excited? Are you ready for gifts?
Oh man, I am ready.
Okay, I'm gonna give you your present first.
Okay, what is it?
I got you something. Now, this is something you've been talking about for a while. You're always like, I need this thing. And so, I got you something special. It's right underneath that bag right there.
Nettie, this is a roll of tape.
It's a roll of tape! You're always saying how you wish you could tape stuff, and I was like, wow, he really needs tape. So, I got all my money together, and I bought the biggest roll of tape that I could find on Amazon.
Nettie, I have no words right now.
Wow. Well, you're welcome, Mr. Dan. Okay, I guess it's time for my gift.
Yeah, actually, Rainy's got to blow the treehouse right now. Let me go get it.
Okay, I'll just wait here patiently again and play Sudoku, although I didn't find it. I guess I could just do it in my head. There's a 4. I think there's a 5. Maybe
All right, Nettie, you ready?
Yes.
I was inspired by the fact that God gave us a gift that lasts forever.
Yeah.
So I wanted to give you a gift that lasts forever.
Okay.
So Randy from Godfather's Pizza agreed to make a cheese and Cheeto pizza, and guess what we named it?
What?
The Netty.
Whoa, you named a pizza after me?
Sure did, good buddy.
It's cheese pizza with Cheetos on top. Holy moly, that's amazing.
Good, I knew you'd love it.
Hey. We're gonna eat this, it's gonna be so good, and then we can use the tape that I got you to tape things to the wall!
Sounds like a plan.
All right, everybody, always remember,
Christmas is all about Jesus.
All right, Mr. Dan, let's get to eating this. Ah, where are the plates? Where are the forks? Where are the knives? Oh, I'm too excited! Oh!
See you next time.